Within central Oregon, 50 miles south of the city of Bend, is a massive circular feature which easily stands out from the surrounding landscape. While some people have claimed that there is no topographic feature here and that the difference in coloration is purely caused by land use differences such as farmland, homes, and forest, this isn't exactly true as you can see in this elevation map. So, what exactly is this strange circular feature in the ground which measures 25 miles wide, largely rises 300 to 900 feet above the surrounding landscape, and has an area of 450 square miles? This unnamed feature has been my single most requested video topic to cover, as I have received hundreds of requests and many dozens of emails from so many different viewers. These messages all ask the same thing, wondering if it was some long-forgotten caldera, impact crater, or dome anticline. After all, satellite imagery and even Google Earth have been used by scientists to spot both small and large features that otherwise would have gone unnoticed. Coming back to the unnamed Oregon feature, let me quickly cross off what it isn't. First of all, I am sorry to disappoint everyone, but the structure is not an impact crater. First off, almost every single complex impact crater on Earth has a raised central peak or one or more rings. And yet, this Oregon structure does not have these. Also, no shock quartz and no impact breccia with melted glass fragments have been found which would indicate an impact structure. Gravity anomaly data also suggests against such a structure, and this feature is additionally not listed in any existing impact crater databases. Second, this Oregon structure is not a caldera. Calderas are depressions, not raised areas, which form in the ground after a very large volcanic eruption drains a significant portion of a volcano's magma chamber. If this feature was to have been a caldera, an eruption involving at least 900 cubic kilometers of tephra would have been involved. And yet, no evidence of a nearly Yellowstone-sized supereruption has been found here. Also, at such a scale, very few large calderas are round, typically being oblong. However, I do want to note that a caldera and some ignimbrite does exist within the larger structure, albeit only measuring 3.7 miles wide. This feature is known as the Wart Peak Caldera and originated during a presumably low-end VEI-6 eruption 4.59 million years ago. Also, unlike this unnamed circular structure in Madagascar or the Eye of the Sahara in Mauritania, Oregon's feature is not a dome anticline associated with the intrusion of a large mass of igneous rock. No evidence of such a vast buried igneous structure exists, as you can see in its magnetic anomaly map. If we look at the rock units of this structure, we can see that isn't a large mass composed of a single rock unit, but rather is represented by multiple different volcanic complexes in addition to the southwestern third being covered by a layer of ash and pumice from Crater Lake's caldera-forming eruption in 5783 BCE. In my opinion, it is best to think of this large circular feature as a chance combination of two uplifted but small-length north-northwest trending horse with a graben between them and on each side of them. That gives us two uplifted blocks of mountains since this portion of Oregon has been undergoing slow extension over millions of years as it lies just beyond the edge of the Basin and Range Province. However, the northern section of both of these horses represents a literal turning point where regional large extensional normal faults suddenly turn to the northeast. This is why so many fault scarps are visible. As for the southeast, the emplacement of the Pliocene-Yamsay mountain volcano buried this region in lava flows, ash, and landslide deposits to hide the fact that it isn't really even close to a perfect circle. Some Pleistocene cinder cones of Sengaltoya and their associated eruptive products then filled portions of the interior graben, creating what appears to be a large singular circular feature. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member Elijah Goverdun for supporting my work.